And now here's our reporter, Lora Windsor, with a segment on infertility.
Having a baby can be the most exciting time in a couple's life, but what happens when their physician tells them it isn't possible because of their age? We spoke with Dr. Sami David, a board-certified OBGYN, with a specialty in fertility and reproductive endocrinology. According to Dr. David, the Sami method is a comprehensive diagnostic approach to determine the root cause of infertility.
Age is not a diagnosis. What I mean by that is when I see patients who have seen other doctors in my specialty, which is reproductive endocrinology and infertility, many of these doctors will say, oh, madam, your problem is your age. You're 43 or you're 35, but your hormone levels indicate you're 43. So consequently, it makes me feel this great injustice is being done to these women. They're being told, oh, your eggs are bad, your eggs are old, you need to do donor egg in vitro, IVF with that eggs of a younger woman. They are making a decision for these women, these couples, based on a single hormone test or their chronological age. What I tell my patients when I see them, anything that will cause infertility in a 23-year-old also causes it in a 43-year-old. So doctor, do not look at the age of the patient, do not look at their day 3 FSH hormone level or their AMH blood level, but look at them in as a person. It's a challenge. You have to help that couple achieve a pregnancy. These women do get the diagnosis and they sort of give up. Their self-esteem, their optimism suddenly diminishes. They're crying in front of the doctor. And how can you say to a patient, this is it, that you will not have a baby of your own? I will take a different approach, which is make a diagnosis. Whether you're 31 or 41, find out why you're not conceiving or find out why you're having miscarriages. Also very much so, I'm seeing these people whose hopes have been destroyed, and they come to me and say, but the doctor so-and-so said this or that, and they get pregnant by simple means, looking for a reason, not just IVF, not just drugs. One of my patients currently pregnant, she was told at age 33, 34, madam, your eggs are old, you'll never have a baby. Well, she's now 6 months pregnant and plans to send the birth announcement to the doctor who said she'd never get pregnant. Whatever your FSH level is, whatever your age is, I will try to find a way of helping you conceive a healthy child. Example, a 47-year-old woman in New York had gone to doctor to doctor to doctor who all said, well, madam, you're 47 years old, you're not going to have a baby of your own. Well, she did. At age 48, she had her daughter, who's now in law school at Columbia. If a woman gets pregnant at age 45, 46, 47, they have a healthy baby, nature will take care of it, okay? If it was not a healthy baby, she would just simply have no heartbeat or have a miscarriage. Let God and nature decide on that, not the doctor.
Dr. David gives us his best advice.
You can start out with something like the book that I publish, Making Babies, a Proven 3-Month Method for Maximum Fertility. That's just a starter. But then you can ask your doctor, who is looking after you, to be very thorough in the evaluation. Give me a diagnosis. Don't tell me I'm 41, that's why I'm not pregnant. That's like a throwback to the days when we used to say, oh, you miscarried, bad luck, try again. That is absurd. We have ways of making people stop miscarrying. We have ways of making people get pregnant at age 41, 42, 43, and further.
Parents need to remember that a baby's well-being starts before conception. So to ensure a healthier pregnancy, remember to live a healthy life. For the American Health Journal, I'm Lora Windsor.